What we're trying to do is to understand what the rules are that govern how antibodies are made and how they decide what to target. I'm Gabriel Victora, I'm an immunologist. Well, immunology is the study of how our bodies respond to invasion by foreign substances. Part of the response is making antibodies. So if you come in with a virus, for example, our bodies are going to make antibodies to that virus, and the next time you see this virus, it's not going to have any effect on you because the antibodies are going to stick to it, and then it's gone. Affinity maturation is the process whereby antibodies become better and better at binding to their targets over time. When you first are exposed to a pathogen, you get an antibody that binds to it, but it doesn't really bind very well. It's enough to get everything started, but it's not really a magic bullet. A B cell is the cell that makes antibodies. Now, the B cell gets recruited into this thing called a germinal center. And this germinal center is sort of a boot camp. The B cell tries to bind to this pathogen. It doesn't bind very well. Then it goes and mutates its genome and makes little variants. And out of these, some of them sometimes bind a little better. The ones that bind better get selected, and they do this again. And then they mutate again, and they get better again. As they do this over and over, there's a sort of Darwinian framework. The best antibodies survive and proliferate more, leave more descendants. So the next time the pathogen comes in, the immune system has no trouble clearing it out because it already trained its antibodies to be very effective. We use several methods to study B cells. A lot of our work is centered on imaging. So we can do things like intravital imaging, where we can actually look at the response happening within a live animal. And this gives us an idea of the cellular dynamics. For example, while the evolution of B cells is happening in the germinal center, they're migrating between different compartments. They spend some time mutating in one compartment and some time being selected in another compartment. By just looking at how these cells transit between the compartments, we can have some idea of how this evolutionary process works. Understanding affinity maturation can help in vaccines in several ways. The issue we have is making the right antibodies to the spots that we want in order to neutralize complicated viruses like influenza and HIV. Affinity maturation can also be important for cancer. The germinal centers, which is where affinity maturation happens, are essentially clumps of B cells that are dividing very, very quickly and mutating their genome, and that's a step away from lymphoma. So understanding how affinity maturation shapes what is being recognized, in addition to how well this thing is being recognized, is where we think the important science lies. I think I would be very happy if someone were to read our rule book and decide, well, this is an important thing for a vaccine, and use that, and then somehow come up with a better vaccine for something like influenza or for HIV. So the impact we expect to have as basic scientists is just writing the rule book that someone can use later to make a vaccine better.